This talk is about computing the gene tree probability based on coliform theory, and this study a phenomenon in the evolution evolutionary biology called incomplete linear sorting. And again, this talk is mainly based on something called coliform theory, and this is one of the major theory behind in the population genetics. So let me first introduce the concept of coalescent and the species tree and gene tree. And shown here in this figure, and this thick tree refers to the evolutionary history of populations, or you can say, you can consider there are a set of closely related species. Let's say in this case, we have A, B, C. We have three species or three populations. And this outline tree here indicates how these populations are related. And this is a population tree or species tree. And here, the embedded tree here, lines embedded in the thick trees is a so-called gene tree. Gene tree represent the evolution history of the individual alleles or genes. And how does this gene tree arise in the population tree? You can see this is arise due to a process called coalescent process. And if you trace backwards in time from this alleles in the population, let's say this ABC, and when you trace long enough, and you will notice that two alleles in the B and C, they coalesce here. In other words, they meet their common ancestor, and this is what we call this a coalescent, right? This is a coalescent. And then you continue to trace backwards, and then you can see all these three alleles or three gene lineages, they all trace back to their common ancestor. So there's another coalescent here, and then you can continue to trace backwards. And so this is the basic concept of coalescent. And a frequently observed situation in the gene tree and the species tree is that the gene tree topology often is can be different from the species tree or population tree topology. This is often called gene tree and species tree discordance. One of the reasons why this happens is because this coalescent process is a stochastic process. There are some underlying uncertainty behind this coalescent process, which will cause the gene tree topology will be different from the species tree topology. I'm going to mention that just a little bit later on, and in this talk, I'm going to just compute this uncertainty. This uncertainty is called this probability of gene trees. Based on the coalescent process, I'm also going to mention several applications of this. All right, so let's take a closer look at how this gene tree and species tree how the gene tree will arise in the species tree from coalescent point of view. And if you say in this case I have a species tree. A, B, C, D, I have four population or species, and then I have a gene tree, A, B, C, D, lowercase a, B, C, D, this gene tree can arise in the species tree by looking at trace backwards in time, and if you trace backwards in time, you can see this lineage A and B will just coalesce, and within this time T1, and in fact, if T1 is larger, then you'll have more chance these two lineages will coalesce. And if you continue backwards in time, you can see this another a coalescent occurs, another coalescent occurs, and continue. And this is how this specific gene tree will arise in the species tree from a coalescent point of view. However, you can also have other type of gene trees from this given species tree. Look on here. This gene trees have a different topology. In this case, BC will be more closely related. And how does this different gene tree arise in the species tree? If you say let's again trace back in backwards in time and A, B, C, D, and then here. You know, maybe this T1 is not long enough, and this two lineages and B just do not coalesce within T1. And then once they reach this ancestral population of all A, B, and C, and so this we have three lineages, and just due to chance, and B and C lineages B and C will coalesce first. And when this happens, you can see this is where you will, and you continue coalesce and here. Now you get a different gene tree topology. And when this happens, this is called this is so-called incomplete lineage sorting. In other words, the lineage A and B should have coalesced when the population A and population B meet their common ancestor, but they didn't. And when this happens, we say this is where incomplete lineage sorting occurs. And this is one frequently observed situation in population genetics. So let me formally define what is the gene tree probability I'm going to compute. So suppose we're given a species tree. And it's easy to see that any gene tree topology can arise, but each way is a different probability. And so the gene tree probability is for some gene tree topology TG, and for a given species tree TS, the probability is the probability of observing this gene tree topology TG for specific species tree TS based on coalescence theory. And intuitively, the larger this gene tree topology is, the more likely you're going to observe this gene tree topology TG under this this species tree. And this quantity has a number of applications in population genetics and evolutionary genomics. And for small gene tree and species tree, one can actually compute this probability by hand, and this actually has been done before. And in this talk, I'm going to describe algorithm. The reason for needing algorithm is because when you have larger gene tree and a species tree, it's going to be more complicated to and also it's more complicated to compute. So the key is to finding a way to efficiently compute this gene tree probability. Okay, so the first algorithm for computing the gene tree probability is given by a paper in 2005, Deggan and Sauter. And their idea is to rely on something called a coalescent history. So coalescent history is that for each coalescent event specified by the gene tree, the coalescent history will specify exactly along which species tree branch this coalescent event occurs. So look at this figure on this slide. And this one actually specifies a coalescent history. It specifies that the lineage B and C, the gene lineage B and C, will coalesce within the time T. That's the species tree branch. And then the second coalescent, which is on the root of the gene tree, will occur above the just above the root of the species tree, and so this specify for each coalescent event, along which species tree branch it occurs. The approach taken by Deggan and Sauter is simply just enumerate all possible coalescent history. And as written here, and they pretty much just summarize this probability of TG and a given coalescent history H for the species TS, and they basically just summing over all possible coalescent history. And the reason that once you fix one coalescent history, this quantity is easier to compute. It's because once the history is the coalescent history is specified, you actually can know for each of species branch, how many gene lineages will coalesce into how many lineages, and this is a classic result in coalescent theory. For a given time t, coalescent time t, and the probability of you have unit lineages on the bottom of the lineage coalesce into V lineages on the top of the lineage, actually has a closed form formula. And since you said the collision history specify where this collision event occurs on which branch, so you actually you know how many lineages collapsing to how many lineages for each of species tree branch, and then you can just multiply them. I'm not going to go into too much details on that. And the main thing I want to say here is that if you take this approach by enumerating all possible collision history, this algorithm is not scalable. So the reason is that for a given gene tree topology, you actually can have many collision history. So this is one collision history. They specify, you know, which where on which collision event occurs. And but this is not the only one. You can also have another collision history depending on where the collision event occur. And this is a figure. This is a table shows in the Deggan Salter paper in 2005, and they show say for one specific tree. Let's look at one, just one. This one. This is a so-called symmetric tree, which is one type of a very simple shape of tree. And you can see that when the number of taxa or number of population grows, and the number of history, collection history, is growing in very rapidly. And in fact, for 20 taxa or 20 populations, you can have a 1.7 billion collection history for this very simple so-called asymmetric trees. So clearly, you know, when you have more and more species tree and we have more and more populations or larger gene trees, and their method become not scalable. So in the paper I published in a journal called Evolution and last year, and I developed new method, which is to compute this gene tree probability. And this is based on a very simple computer science technique called dynamic programming. This algorithm computed the exact same thing as the Deggan Salter's algorithm. And in other words, it's an exact algorithm, and just much faster. And this is based on a new concept called ancestral configuration, or AC. And my method has been implemented in a program called Stealth, and can be downloaded in my personal webpage. Okay, so let me quickly introduce what is the basic concept of is ancestral configurations. Ancestral configurations, or AC, specify under certain positions in the species tree, the set of gene lineages alive at that point. And you look on here. Let's take some examples here. And first, I label this internal lineages of a gene tree. So in this case, I have EFG. This is internal lineages of gene tree. And and let's look at the possible ACs right at the point of a speciation, but a little bit earlier than the speciation. Look at this point, and on the very bottom, the accident time, we only have one, say, in population A, we only have one lineage, and so this is just A. So this set of lineages alive at that point, just A, and there's no other choices. And on this point, when you first have this population A and B, they found their common ancestor, you still only have one choice, which is A and B. You do not have time to coalesce for AB because you just arrived at that point. And but if you are right here, when you have when you reach the speciation of population A, B, and C, and now you have choices. You can have actually two choices. One is ABC. ABC means that AB just do not coalesce, or you have EC. EC means that A and lineage A and B will just coalesce within this branching time, right? And this is the two choices. And if you go, you know, above one level, and you have three choices, and A, B, C, D, or E, C, D, or F, D. F, D, when you have, you know, a lineage A and B, the lineage E will coalesce with lineage C within this period of time. And you have three possible configurations, or AC. And the key here is that I'm going to define the probability of AC. I call PAC. PAC is the probability of AC of observing the set of lineages under this point of V that coalesce into those specified by the AC. So in other words, this probability of AC is the probability of observing these lineages specified by the AC. And then I'm going to establish a set of recurrence, and this recurrence of this probability of AC will allow me to efficiently compute this this gene tree probability. So let's take a quick example here. I have time. Let's suppose I have time t, and on the root of this this species tree, and on the right hand side, I have a very simple AC. I only have one choice, which is d, and to the left hand side, and I have I said before, I have two choices, A, B, C, or E, C. And under root, I said before, I have three choices. And each of the probability of this different AC can be computed in a recurrence. Look at this example, and let's say ECD. ECD is formed by the lineages when you just arriving from the left, so you become EC. And you have D. So these two will merge under this root and to create ECD. And so to compute the probability of ECD, you need to estimate what's the probability of going to observe this lineage EC right below the root from the left-hand side of the species tree. And so you need to estimate this. And how you can get lineages EC on the left branch right below the root? You either go from the lineage the AC ABC and the bottom of this branch, or you go from the EC. All right, so two choices, and then you can define a transition probability, which I call this a transition probability from AC1 to AC2 for some given time of t, and this transition probability can be computed by this closed form formula just mentioned earlier, right? And then this established the recurrence, the probability of EC prime, which is just right below the root from the left, is equal to the probability of ABC and the bottom of the left branch times the transition probability of you transit from ABC to EC within time of t. Plus, this is a second choice. You have a probability of EC times transition probability of EC remains EC within time of t. So this is essentially the probability that EC do not coalesce within time of t along that branch. And based on this recurrence, I can develop some algorithm. It's like in evolution genetics called similar to this peeling algorithm by Felsch Einstein, or it's simply just dynamic programming. And I omit this details. And what I want to emphasize is that why this algorithm is better. And as I mentioned before, and for one type of tree, this is a maximum symmetric trees, and the Deglan-Salters algorithm, when you enumerate all possible histories, the number of histories is actually very large, it's growing exponentially. And however, if you look at the number of ACs in my method, this just n times of n plus 1 over 2, n is the number of populations. So it's a polynomial. And look at this number here, and let's suppose we have 20 taxa or 20 populations. And my method only have 210 ACs. And I said before, if you enumerate our possible history, you have 1.77 histories, and so it's much faster. So I want to mention what functionalities implemented by my program Stealth. And Stealth has two mode of operations. And the first one is that if you suppose you are interested in some specific species tree and say TS, and you collect a set of gene tree topology T1, T2, TK, and Stealth will compute the gene tree probability for this each of this gene tree topology T1 and T2 and T3, basically just compute the probability and take a product of all this gene tree topology, and Stealth can also find the optimal branch lengths. In other words, has an optimization to find what's the optimal branch lengths of a species tree for this species you are given. The second mode of my program stealth is that it's also can infer the species tree or population tree from the gene tree topologies T1, T2, and TK. So in this case, you do not give a stealth any like a species tree to consider, and stealth we actually find the maximum likelihood estimate. Or MLE of the of a species tree from this given set of a gene tree topology, and this use some kind of local search to find the optimal trees, and in terms of accuracy it's more accurate than the existing maximum likelihood estimate of a species tree, and based on simulation I'm going to omit a simulation result, you can see that from my paper, and in terms of efficiency my program stealth works for up to 30 populations, and anywhere up to say 100 or to 500 gene trees, so it's much more scalable than some Bayesian approaches that people also use. So that's all. You can find my paper, and you are interested in more details, and also programs to download from my personal webpage. That's all.
Questions, and we have a question. Could you repeat the question?
Sure.
The data sets that you test the methods on are mostly eukaryotes, I guess?
I didn't really mention the type of data, and actually it's very flexible, because data I use is gene tree. So if you can infer a gene tree from your, say, DNA gene sequences, and you can use my method, and only you need a topology, and so you can apply to all kinds of organism you want to study. But I want to emphasize that this model is based on coalescent theories. In other words, we really assume they are like a closely related species or populations. All right, so this is more suitable for that. Okay, so the question is, there are many different genes in the species. How we can choose that? And if you one assumption I do make is that look on here, and if you have multiple genes, and I take a product of the gene tree of each of the genes for a given species tree, and the underlying assumption, implicit assumed, is that these genes are kind of like a little bit far apart. So pretty much this assume free recombination across genes. So this is the one assumption. Other than that, I don't really make other major assumption about what genes you want to choose. So the question is how large the program can handle, and I have tried in my personal simulation. If you want to compute the only compute gene tree probability, you can have as large as 30 populations or 30 species, and each with say one or few gene alleles. Inferring species tree from say 100 or 500 genes tend to be more computational demanding, right? And you need to do a lot of optimization to find what's the optimal species tree topology and branch lenses. And also depends on the type of topology of gene trees you have. Yeah, but it's in general much more scalable than previous algorithms.
I'm just wondering how would that confound
So the question is what about like a gene flow or horizontal gene transfer in some organism, and in my program I don't deal with the complexity caused by gene flow, but there are some other people extending this work to allow gene flow, and